Alrighty folks, so today we're going to go through some different types of insulins and how you would draw these up and administer them to your pet. In veterinary medicine, we can use human insulins or veterinary specific insulins. And we're going to talk about the different types of syringes we might need to use based on the different concentrations of insulin. The examples we're going to use today are this Lantus insulin pen, which is a human insulin often used in cats. It is going to be a U100 insulin, meaning that it is 100 units per mil, which means we will use an orange capped U100 syringe. We'll also talk about Vetsulin, which is commonly used in veterinary medicine, but is a U40 insulin, which means 40 units to the mil, and we're going to use a red capped U40 syringe for this one. A good reason to make sure you know the difference between the syringes is if you see we dose insulin based on units, and 10 units on one syringe is going to be a very different amount than 10 units on the other syringe. We'll go ahead and start with the U100 pen. These pens look as such. They're nice and clear. They're a solution, so they don't need to be shaken, and you want to make sure that it always looks clear if it starts clear. These can come with a pen needle that connects to the actual pen and is dosed by twisting the edge of the pen to the correct units. You also can use this like a vial and draw up your insulin with your syringe. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how we would do that. Ideally, if you have an alcohol swab available, you'd like to clean the top to make sure you're not getting any contamination. You'll need to take the cap off the end of your syringe so that you're actually able to draw up. You'll then insert the needle into the pen and invert it, drawing up to the correct dosage for your pet. And then this will be ready to be given to the pet. For the Vetsulin, it's in a vial already. It's kind of cloudy in nature, and this is one that you would shake well. Some insulins will ask you to roll gently rather than shake well, so you should always look at the package to see what you need to do for that. Again, you'd like to swab the top if you have an alcohol swab available to prevent any kind of contamination. You'll take the cap off the end of your syringe as such, and just like with the insulin pen, you'll insert the needle into the vial and draw up the dose for your pet. And then this would be ready to be given to your pet as well. So now we're going to show you how to actually give the insulin to your pet. Sometimes they will be a little bit wiggly, so if you need to change position, you're more than welcome to, you know, pause and adjust. The main thing you want to think about is that this medication is supposed to be dispensed under the skin. So you're going to tent the skin up into a little triangle to allow you to put the needle where it's just under the skin. So I'm going to go ahead and take the cap off to get my needle ready. I'm going to tent her skin up near her shoulder blades. You don't want to try to hit the same spot every time, but this tends to be the best place to administer. You want to make sure that you get the needle under the skin, especially on a fluffy cat, and then you dispense the syringe. You can offer them treats to make it a more positive experience, but being such a tiny needle, oftentimes they don't seem to notice it a whole lot anyway. When you're doing your cleanup afterwards, you want to make sure that you return your insulin to the refrigerator and give your pet lots of love for being such a good patient for you. The same kind of concept of giving insulin to a cat would apply to dogs as well.